Holding pressure is when you hold the front tire up in the air while you go over an obstacle. Not only does it look cool, but it can be used to maintain traction as well as give you time to set the front tire down exactly where you want it. You can learn this on just about any obstacle, but it's smart to start small while you build your confidence. Here I have a very small log. It's really easy just to ride over, but if I want to hold pressure on it, instead of letting off the throttle early and getting my body weight forward to set the front tire down right on the other side, I'm going to stay on the throttle a little bit longer to drive the rear tire into and on top of the log. And I'm also going to keep my body weight back to try to hold that wheelie. My goal is to land both tires on the other side at the same time. At first, you shouldn't be too worried about slipping the clutch or covering the rear brake, but if you do get it a little bit too high, it's good to have a finger on the clutch and a foot ready to get on the rear brake, just in case you're about to loop out. You can pull the clutch in, get on the brake, and bring it down safely. Now I have a slightly bigger obstacle, and this is a great time to start bringing the clutch into it. Instead of just pulling the wheelie and trying to land on the other side, you can start to slip the clutch about 3/4 of the way up and maintain a little bit of throttle so you can keep it exactly where you want it. You can also straighten your legs a bit and put a lot of pressure into the foot pegs while pulling back on the handlebars. This will keep the suspension compressed and keep a lot of pressure on the rear tire so you can maintain traction and set the front tire down exactly where you want it. Again, you shouldn't need the rear brake on this one, but it's always good to be ready. If you get a little bit too much throttle, the front end comes up too high, you get on the rear brake and bring it down safely. Here I have an example of when holding pressure is the best option. If I'm going to go over both of these logs and I try to set my front tire in between, it's going to be very difficult to get the front tire up over the second one. It's really tight spacing and this log is very slippery. So the best option is to hold pressure over the first one, set my front tire on the second one, then I can just focus on driving the rear tire in, up, and over the second one clean. So to do that, I'm going to give a little bit extra effort on this first one to make sure the rear tire gets all the way to the top. If I just drive it in slow, like it's dry, and expect to just slip the clutch and hold the front tire up, probably gonna spin and go to skid plate. So I wanna make sure to give it a little bit extra throttle, a little extra body to help the bike up and stay back long enough to when the rear tire's on top. Once I know it's on top, then I can get on the rear brake and set the front tire down exactly where I want it. If I don't get on the rear brake, I might end up going a little bit too far, maybe skid plating the second one. So bringing the rear brake into it now will give you that control for ultimate accuracy to make sure you set the front right where you need to so you can stay clean. Hopefully that gives you a good handle of what holding pressure is all about. It can be done in any of the trials gears and on just about any obstacle, almost any technique, and it's constantly done as the obstacles get bigger and you need to hold the front tire in the air over them. So remember to start small, build your confidence, and hopefully you'll be ready for it when you need to do it in a section.